Hello people, it's me, Ginny Metheral, fourth generation witch and bloody good at it too. I've got a bit of a quick one for you today because I have recently purchased a very brand new tarot deck. Now I haven't done tarot since I was a teenager because I just use a pack of playing cards. As you can see, beautiful isn't it? I think it cost me 99p, it's my current pack. I don't necessarily treat them any differently. I don't wrap them in, you know, pretty muslins and tie ribbons around them and smoke them. I just use them and sometimes we play snap. And so I thought a change would be rather good. So I have bought myself a traditional tarot deck. So I thought we'd do a quick divination with my new tarot deck and then ask the same question from the cards, the playing card deck, and see where we get. I don't use books to interpret my tarot cards. I never have because I just look at them and they tell me what I think they need to say. So it's a feeling I get. So they speak to me as opposed to me looking through a book and going, oh, well, wands normally signify this and a, I don't know. I'm not very good at that because I find it a bit boring and a bit too structured for me. I'm much freer with my divination. I'm not bad at divination, actually. In fact, I'm bloody good. Now, the cards never lie. So let's see what the tarot cards say. So the pack I have chosen is a fairly standard original tarot deck, which is made by this bloke called Arthur Edward Waite under Pamela Coleman Smith's help in about the 1920s. So it's a fairly traditional and well-known tarot deck. I don't really like anything too way out because I find the pictures a bit off-putting and so I can't read them as well. Of course, the first thing that you always do with a deck is to shuffle them. But it is important that you should hold in your mind the question whilst you're shuffling this deck. So our question is, what would YouTube like Ginny Metheral to do? Once you are happy with the shuffle, I always just cut the deck. And then I'm going to lay the cards out on the table in a crescent shape so that I can begin choosing them. Now the way I do this is to run my hands slowly over the cards, and when the area underneath my palm feels a bit hot, I know that I'm close to a card. So it felt hot, that one. So, and again, I'm going to choose for a second card. There's something going on here, I can feel it. And it's that one. And I'll just check, yes, it's that one. And for my third card, there's something going on here. It's getting a bit warm. It's one of these. Yeah, I can feel something going on here. That one. Brilliant. So these are now the three cards that I've got. Before we look at the cards, I'm just going to use my pendulum to check that they are the correct ones that I have chosen. Let me see if I can get the pendulum still. Yeah, there we go. We've got the backwards and forwards movement, which for me is a yes. So let's turn them over and have a look. Right, we've got the Four of Wands, the Ten of Wands, and Temperance. Right, I'm going to have a little think about this. It's going to take me a little while before I can come up with what they mean. After a little puzzling and with the help from my pendulum, I think this first one, this Four of Wands, is representative of myself and my channel on YouTube. The wands show that I'm giving you just a very, very small amount of information, the basic of witchcraft, which is very true. I haven't gone particularly in depth. And so I think this is a good representation for me. The Temperance card, which shows an angel holding some cups, I believe represents YouTube or the YouTube audience. And it shows that the YouTube audience isn't particularly way out. It's a fairly mainstream audience. And I think that this card represents it. And I think what these cards are saying is that YouTube, which is the Temperance, wants me, the Four of Wands, to give them the Ten of Wands, which is much, much more information than I already have. They want to squeeze me for everything that I've got. I think that's what the Nine of Wands is saying. So we've got me as the Four of Wands, my information, which I need to get out and produce for the pleasures
of YouTube is represented by the Ten of Wands, and that's what YouTube is looking for, which is represented by Temperance. So leaving those cards to the side, we're now going to do the same thing with playing cards. So while shuffling the cards, I'm thinking of the question, what does YouTube want from Ginny Metheral? Shuffle the cards away. I'm also now going to split the pack, which is my want. Lay the cards out and using my hand again, find out where it gets hot. There's something going on here. I can feel my palm getting a bit hot, so it's one of these ones. And again, for the second card, something. Oh, and sometimes it takes a bit of time sometimes to get this right, because you've got to make sure that, you know, you're choosing the right card. So there's something here. That one, I think. And for the final card, there's something over here. Or is it? Yeah, this is a difficult one actually. It's eluding me. I think it must be, yeah, that one, okay. So we've got our three cards, let's turn them over. I've got a Queen of Hearts, an Ace of Spades, and a Three of Spades. This is almost exactly the same. So I'll put them in order for you. The Queen of Hearts, as you can see, is representation of me. I am the Queen of Hearts, the Ace of Spades. This corresponds with the Temperance card and shows YouTube. And the Three of Spades corresponds with the Ten of Wands and shows that YouTube wants my knowledge. Slightly darker knowledge, though, than what I'm prepared to give, I think, and this one. I'm not sure about that. Interesting. So they are almost exactly the same. YouTube wants slightly darker magic from me, according to the playing cards. However, I don't think I'm going to indulge YouTube in that.
So a quick look at how to divine with both playing cards and tarot decks. Now, I think I will continue using the tarot decks for a bit because it's slightly more, you know, it's a bit different. There is a lot more cards in it. The way I read cards is to feel what they say. So am I right, is what I'd like to know. Does YouTube want to get every ounce of information out of me so that it can use it? Let me know in the comments below. And if you like this video, give us a subscribe and a like, and I'll see you in my next one.